suddenly because of a story he was working on. His name was Chauncey Bailey, and just this past week he was honored posthumously with the George Polk Award, one of journalism's most prestigious honors, for the story that may have cost him his life. The story Bailey was working on was about, of all things, a bakery, but not any ordinary bakery. It's called Your Black Muslim Bakery, and it was once a multi-million dollar business, as well as a major religious and political power in Oakland. But the bakery's leaders were known for using tactics right out of The Godfather. Bailey was investigating some of those tactics, which made some bakery leaders angry. And angering the bakery was risky business, as Oakland police knew all too well.
Rumors about them killing people or forcing them to do stuff that they didn't want to do was rampant throughout the community. So
people were scared to talk.
People were scared to call the police.
Assistant Chief Howard Jordan has been an Oakland cop for 19 years. He says Your Black Muslim Bakery was on police radar for a long time. It looks harmless enough from the outside, but at its height, the bakery employed about 200 people, many of them ex-convicts who converted to Islam. And some of them didn't seem to spend too much time in the kitchen.
The Black Muslim Bakery opened its doors here in Oakland more than 30 years ago, selling bean pies and fish sandwiches. It was started by a man who called himself Yusuf Bey, a black Muslim who preached a philosophy of self-reliance and self-esteem. Over the years, the bakery provided jobs and hope to hundreds
of African-Americans in Oakland's inner city. But the positive outward image of the bakery never told the whole story. Inside that building, there were some very sinister things going on.
It didn't seem like many folks in the bakery were baking too many pies. I mean, it seemed to have just become a criminal enterprise.
That's a fairly accurate statement, sort of went from the business that was conducting legitimate business to business interested in doing fraud, real estate fraud, assaults, robberies, vandalism, to promote a criminal cause versus a religious cause.
But in 2002, bakery founder Yusuf Bey was arrested on 27 counts of abusing and raping 12 and 13-year-old girls taken in by the bakery. He was accused of fathering children by them and of stealing their welfare payments. According to many reports, Bey fathered more than 40 children by different women at the bakery. As the Bey family and its business grew, they opened a dozen stores and owned a security company, a dry cleaner, a school, and properties in the area. In the process, the bakery became something of a law unto itself.
A lot of Oakland cops told me that they left certain neighborhoods to the Bey family.
That particular business,
yeah, however they want.
Reporter Chris Thompson revealed the bakery's secrets in the East Bay Express, a weekly paper. He exposed a trail of violence, brutality, and fraud that stretches back almost a decade. Members of the bakery were furious.
What happened after the stories were published?
Somebody smashed down all our windows.
Did you personally receive any threats?
Somebody would call up and say, Mr. Thompson, I just want you to know that your days are numbered, your time is up, you've screwed up for the last time. But the creepiest thing was when they started following me home.
That's when Thompson decided to get out of town for a few months. While he was gone, the bakery's charismatic leader, Yusuf Bey, died. His funeral was attended by 1,000 mourners from all parts of Oakland.
So when Yusuf Bey Sr. died, there was really a power struggle within the organization.
Yes, there was a power struggle between the younger and the older Bey family members.
This was not your typical boardroom power struggle. Two of Bey's successors were murdered, and a third was wounded in an ambush. The last man standing was Yusuf Bey IV, the 19-year-old son of founder Yusuf Bey, and one of five sons he named after himself. That's where reporter Chauncey Bailey picked up the story. Bailey was a veteran of Oakland newspapers and television who worked for a weekly African-American newspaper called the Oakland Post. In July, Bailey was tipped off to serious financial problems inside the bakery by this man, Salim Bey.
The story you told Chauncey Bailey, did that lead to his murder?
I believe that it led directly to his murder.
Salim Bey is not one of Yusuf Bey Sr.'s biological children. He's one of the dozens of people Bey spiritually adopted, who took the family name. Salim Bey was a leader of the bakery until he was forced out in that power struggle.
I told Chauncey Bailey that the bakery was about to be shut down, even though we were bankruptcy.
This was a culmination of 3 years of the bakery being a
embezzled and fraud and forgery and different things that led it to be this way.
You asked Chauncey Bailey to keep your name out of it. Why?
I knew that it would be inflammatory and that the people who would take it that way were dangerous.
Over the years, the bakery had earned a reputation for intimidation. What you're seeing here is what they called a show of force. It was taped by KPIX-TV, the CBS station in San Francisco, outside an Oakland tow yard, where bakery members were demanding that a car be released. This is a smaller version of the close-order military drills that up to 50 bakery members would put on to intimidate the community.
The maker, the owner, cream of the bread, earth, God of the universe, sir!
Another show of force was caught by a security camera. Yusuf Bey IV and some of his followers were charged with trashing a neighborhood liquor store. Bey, who's pleaded not guilty, said the action was taken because alcohol is against Islamic law. After taking over the bakery, Yusuf Bey IV went on a crime spree.